Pitfire commentary number 356. The guy with no gamer tag has sent in Rainbow Six Siege, and this is part of it. What the fuck? Operation White Noise? Is this like a DLC? Is this a certain mission? I don't know, but guess I'm about to find out in this motherfucker, ain't I? Anyways, as I've been saying, this is part of the whole request that I did. Shit, I did a while ago. And the funny thing is, I thought that I was actually going to get this, I thought I was going to get the videos before the DLC came out for Destiny Warmind, because I thought it was a pretty easy one. I said, just send me some shit that's popular on Twitch. Little did I realize, people that follow me don't really like Twitch. Or they at least don't want... How the fuck did he sneak... Oh, is this like a camera? Oh, it's like a, not a camera, like a remote control car or some shit. Yeah, because I was like, there's no fucking way some humans crawling on the floor that fucking quick. Ain't no fucking way that shit's happening. Look at that shit. He get under that fucking door? Yeah, nope, not happening in that bitch, man. So anyway, like I said, this was the whole request and whatnot. And I told people I wanted games that were in the top 20. What the fuck? You know, if you didn't see that shit quick enough, obviously he was using a grappling hook and he was rappelling up the side of the building, but that motherfucker just looked like he straight walked up the side of a damn building. That was pretty damn funny, this motherfucker, man. So anyway, like I was saying, that this is part of that whole request or whatever the hell it is. So naturally, you know, people that 2v2, all these people are dying and you didn't do shit? So, whatever. So these are the people that sent in their videos. And obviously, I know Rainbow Six Siege has well been in the top 25 for quite a while. And you know what's funny about this? This game has sort of had sort of a comeback on its own. You know, we talked about comebacks before. I talked about The Division. They've had a comeback ever since they launched their game. Final Fantasy had one of the most famous ones where they turned the motherfucker off. You're poisoned. You walked in the poison, asshole. Oh, you're dead, right? Nope. Oh, you got needles. Yeah. How the fuck did that guy not kill you? Yeah, I said where the money is. Don't they gotta come to the money? I assume they gotta come to where the money is. Yeah, just hide where the money is. Oh, no, there's another door over there. Yeah, you get fucked up real quick. That leaning shit is kind of fun. I gotta admit, that is a pretty good idea. So in any event, this game was initially launched to decent reviews. I don't think anybody's gonna argue with that. It launched to decent reviews, but essentially people were like, you know, it has fucking problems. It needs some patches. It needs some help. You need to do a little bit better of a job. There's that motherfucker. You just like sat in there and didn't even... I don't know how the fuck he didn't kill you. But anyway, this game launched to, you know, decent reviews, but they all said the same thing, that it needs some help. And it's going to be a decent game once it gets that help. So eventually it got the help that it needed. That, who the fuck does this? Ubisoft does this one? I assume they did this one. Right? Yeah, I think they had to do this one. So anyway, they updated the game. They rolled out all the patches that the game needed. They rolled out a lot of the competitive features that the game really needed. And sure enough, this game has taken off quite a bit. And one of the big things that made this game popular is the competitive nature of this game. A lot of the competitive gaming scene has taken over this particular game. Now, I don't watch any gaming crap. I don't watch this fucking... video game championships and all that super shit. Nope, don't fucking watch that shit. But essentially, I do, you know, go over to Twitch every now and then. And part of the reason why I was going over there was I was trying to see what's in the top 25 over the past couple of weeks, you know, because you want to make sure that you capture shit, right? I want to make sure that the people that are actually, you know, sending in the content, they're actually sending in things that are in the top 25, that I'm not getting fucking, you know, Japanese cunt pun from fucking Tree Hugger. So I had to make sure, and I was going over there, and I know that they had some championship shit or something. I don't know what the fuck it was. I mean, you know, everybody was in the goddamn arena watching a whole bunch of jackasses play fucking video games and cheering on a big screen TV. And I'm sorry, man, this is not a fucking sporting event. We could have that conversation for another day. I think I've had that conversation plenty of fucking times. Not a fucking sporting event. Spectating event, sure. Sporting event, no. Never. Mm-mm. Not esports. This will never be a sport, no matter how many times they try to call this shit a sport in this motherfucker, man. But anyway, get into the action. I know the whole premise of this, and I'll tell you right now, I would fucking suck at this game. This is basically search and destroy. And one of the issues that I have with any kind of video game is I'm not good at games where all I get is one life, and then once I'm dead, that's it. I don't wake back up. I don't respawn. None of that shit. Because part of the reason what makes me decent in games is I learn and I adapt to the other team. Yeah, you may kill me, and I may see how you killed me. For example, let's say you have a drop shotter, right? One knife kills in this game, oh yeah, I'd be fucking irritated and pissed off in that motherfucker. But let's say I go up against a team of drop shotters, right? I know that every time I'm going to be engaging in these fucking fools, they're going to be drop... That motherfucker! Oh, man. Now, do you heal or whatever it is? I don't know if you're healing this motherfucker. But anyway, I know if I'm playing against a team of drop shotters, I know that every single time that I face off against these clowns, I'm going to have to make sure that I... What? I didn't even see what the fuck it did. I'm going to have to make sure that I adjust to people that they're always going to be on the floor. They're going to drop as soon as they see you. They're going to take the floor, and then they're going to shoot you in your fucking ankle. So you have to be prepared for shit like that. So naturally, that's what I do. I'm prepared for it. I know that maybe I have to play lower. I have to shoot lower. I have to shoot at kneecaps or some shit. And then when they're on their way down on the floor, I might pop their head off when they're fucking falling to the ground. So you adjust when you learn from your enemies. But when you're playing search and destroy, it's kind of hard to adjust because then you die and then you got to wait for the other round. And then once you wait for the other round, maybe the other round they make adjustments again as well. So part of the reason why I don't play elimination type games is I hate the fact that I don't have enough time to really adjust to what they're doing. That just frustrates me. So that's why I'm not a big fan of those type of elimination games. Now, in the competitive nature, absolutely. It's great for a competitive version of a game. But for the games that I like to play, no, absolutely not. I never liked Search and Destroy when I played on Call of Duty games. I don't like Trials in Destiny or whatever the fuck it is. So I'm not going to be bothered with that shit. Now, as of the release of this video, this dude was just straight leaning in this motherfucker. So as of the release of this video, I was literally just watching the Black Ops, whatever the fuck, the one that they're going to show. Black Ops 4 is going to be, you know, the Battle Royale mode and all that shit. And they're not going to have, traditional campaign. They're going to have 85 fucking things of zombies. Oh man. You know, I don't want to get too much into this because I don't want this to talk about Black Ops. I want us to focus on Rainbow Six. But I felt like Treyarch looked at every idea. They said, you know what? Fans right now are having issues liking our games, right? So let's just take every fucking idea possible that fans have liked over the past few years and try to throw that into one complete game. That's what it feels like. It's like, okay, this studio did this well. This studio did that well. Let's throw it all into our game. And it just seems like they have a mishmash of games all together in one. And then they don't even have a campaign. I just don't get it. I'm not going to bother. I mean, I've already said it. I don't bother with Treyarch games, and I definitely won't bother with that one. And they're so fucking scared of Red Dead Redemption that they're releasing in October. So that goes to show you, they are fucking panicked over the fact that Red Dead Redemption is going to kick their fucking ass, man. So anyway, here's my thing. I get the barbed wire, right? I really do get it as a deterrent. Why are you not scaling it up? In other words, why do you not cover the whole door in barbed wire? You know what I mean? I mean, maybe that's just me. Like, you see, he just walked right over that shit. I don't know if the enemies can walk right over that shit, but you can walk right over that shit. So why don't you attach it to the top of a doorway and then roll the shit down to the floor so you almost have to either duck under it or you have to move it some way, shape, or form, and you have to get around it. And if you're prone, like that asshole right there, you clearly don't have the mobility of someone who's standing up, right? So you would want to force them into ducking. And look at that motherfucker camping. Oh man, if I got on the top of the steps, I'd just go teabag that motherfucker. So I don't get why you just, oh yeah, let me just drop that shit on the floor, whatever the hell. So I see there's no radar. I don't know if there's, look at this idiot, just keep continuing to crawl. I can't tell if you're in the same lobby or not. I guess I gotta look at the names to see if you're still on the same, whatever the hell. So I see that it says gizmo mine triggered. So I guess those things that you were putting on the wall, that was the mine. That was kind of like the, damn, you missed all those shots. I guess that was kind of like the, what is that? A sensor or whatever the hell it is. So then you know that, oh, okay, this motherfucker shot my sensor. So now I know that exactly what the fuck I'm supposed to be doing. So I'm trying to see if your teammates are dying or they're dying. 3 versus 5 means you have the 3, they have the 5. That's what I would assume. So I guess you're going to have to make some kind of heroic moment in this motherfucker. Go 1v5 in this bitch. Enemy stop securing. I don't know what the fuck this shit is. So he shot his ass in the back. Smart moves. So killed those two. So now you're down to one more left. Oh, there he is. You've been spotted. Yeah, run away. I don't know how the fuck he didn't shoot you there. I mean, you just got through that doorway pretty quickly. So clearly he doesn't know how to fucking shoot or whatever the hell it is. So look at, oh damn, look at that blood splatter on the wall. I like that shit. Yeah, that's pretty good right there. Team deathmatch, secure area, orange team wins. And I know you kicked their ass pretty good. Yeah, 8 kills, It even shows your connection, so your connection's pretty crap. Oh, man. So, anyways, like I said, guys, if you haven't by now, you can go over to Prestige Gamers. I'm asking for games in the top 25. So, right now, I would assume Destiny 2 would count because of the DLC. I'm sure people are watching that motherfucker. So, if you're playing it, you guys can send in some footage. As always, rate, comment, subscribe, and all that good shit. And I'll see you guys in the next video.